Hey guys, welcome back to the Fergie Time Podcast. Today, we are joined by Bo Feekins from the Inside Arsenal channel, and we will be debating, will Christian Pulisic reach the level of peak Eden Hazard? Before we start, I do wanna explain what I mean by that peak Eden Hazard level. While he won the Player of the Season in the Premier League in the 2014-2015 season, I believe his best year was the 2018-2019 season at Chelsea, where he had 16 goals and 15 assists in the Premier League. Bo, do you think Pulisic can reach that level?
I think it's going to be very difficult. It's going to be very difficult to reach a level like that. I think when Eden Hazard in that 2018 season, he was untouchable. I mean, he was genuinely, you could make an argument that he was probably at that point one of the best players on the planet. So I think a lot of the Pulisic-Hazard comparisons are very early. It's very early to make those comparisons, and I think it's very unjust to a player like Pulisic. Let's not get it wrong. Pulisic had a very up and down year, and towards the end of the year, he was in good form and he started banging in goals. But let's not get it wrong. Pulisic had a very somewhat inconsistent season, and so I think all of a sudden, just after a few good run of games, to all of a sudden start comparing him with the likes of Eden Hazard, who at one point was one of the best players on the planet during when he was in peak form, I think that's a little unfair to Pulisic. And don't get me wrong, Pulisic is going to be a superb player in the Premier League. He's already shown that he has the potential to reach very high levels, but to say he can reach as high a level as Hazard was when he was at Chelsea is a little unjust. So I guess in a long way, no, I do not believe that Pulisic will reach the level of Eden Hazard.
Yeah, I agree with you about it being a very high mark to hit for sure. I think during that season, we could argue that Hazard was a top five player in the world, no doubt, in my opinion. Would you agree with that statement?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I would even move it up to top three. I think just behind Messi and Ronaldo, he was right there.
Okay, so Bo, I have pulled up some statistics for you comparing Pulisic's age 2021 season with Hazard's age 2021 season. So this year, of course, Pulisic 25 appearances, 9 goals, 4 assists. Comparing that to Hazard's age 2021 season, he in Ligue 1, which is very important to make a distinction because that's obviously not the same level as the Premier League. 38 appearances, 20 goals, 18 assists, which is very, very impressive in its own right. However, I think a better comparison is actually Hazard's age 21-22 season, where that was his first season in the Premier League. Like it was Pulisic's first season in the Premier League, he had 9 goals and 11 assists. So yes, he did considerably better than Pulisic in his first season in the Premier League. I think in terms of just being an all-around player, there's definitely more consistency there from Hazard. I think the big test for Pulisic, I think right now it's a bit ambitious to say he could reach that level of Hazard, but I think the true test for Pulisic moving forward will be next season. I think as he ages up one more year, as he's made that transition to the Premier League, if he can then step up his game again to another level, or whether he will remain that player that has a lot of talent but is overall quite inconsistent. What are your thoughts on that?
Yeah, I think when Hazard came into the league, he was actually a very similar player to Pulisic. I think the comparisons from when they first started in the Premier League are very fair comparisons. I think Hazard had a lot of talent, just like Pulisic has a lot of talent, but he didn't have as much of the end product side of his game. You know, he wasn't as consistent in getting goals, getting assists, and I think Hazard, throughout the years at Chelsea, he worked with a lot of great coaches, you know, the likes of Conte, Mourinho, even Maurizio Sarri. He worked with a lot of great coaches who developed him. I mean, every year Eden Hazard got better, and then obviously he had a few years that were a little blip when Chelsea were inconsistent, but besides those occasional years, Eden Hazard got better and better every year. And I think I really agree with the point that you made about Pulisic. His real test is next season. Can he take what happened this season and build on it? Or is he just going to have a similar output of inconsistency? And then that's where players like Hazard separate themselves from players like Pulisic, in the sense that every year they just get better and better. Whereas if a player like Pulisic, say next season, he comes in and he has a similar season, you know, he has great moments, he has bad moments, and there's just too much inconsistency, then he'll never be able to reach the level like Hazard. And so truly, it's always about building. It's always about building your game. But I do believe that Pulisic has a very, very high ceiling. I mean, he's shown it this year, especially towards the end of the season. Some of the moments in games, I mean, he would get the ball, he'd pick up the ball, and he'd even look a little bit like Hazard in the sense that he'd just run at defenders and they would get nowhere near him. So yeah, I think Pulisic has a super high ceiling, but I think it's about, in future years, can he continue to develop? And can Chelsea themselves continue to develop under Lampard? I think an underappreciated part of football players really go in sync with football teams. If football teams are on the rise, football players go on the rise. And if football teams are on the fall, football players also go on the fall. So if Chelsea can build under Lampard, then I'm sure Pulisic will continue to build as an individual player. But that's another question itself. Can Chelsea continue to be as consistent? And can Pulisic continue to be as consistent?
Yeah, I agree with you. And a major area in Pulisic's game where I think he needs to improve is dribbling in tight spaces, because that's, I think, where Eden Hazard kind of made his bread and butter, was not just in the open field when he has that electric pace to get past players and run into that green grass, but was actually when he picked up the ball in a tight space, and then from that tight space, worked himself around two or three players to then find that open grass to run into. And I think that's an area of Pulisic's game where if he develops that, then he could potentially hit Hazard's level. But right now, Pulisic in those tight spaces is not quite as effective as he is in that open space when he's got plenty of room to run into. And for me, I think if he wants to take that next step, that's where he's kind of got to look to improve. And it's not an easy thing to do. There's very few footballers in the world that can beat two or three players in a tight space and then find that green grass and get after it. So that's a big step for him. And I think if he can look to make that improvement over the next two or three seasons, I think he has a very good chance at reaching Hazard's peak level. I mean, we are a little biased, or I'm a little biased being American. I'd love to see Pulisic reach that level. I just don't know if that's maybe at this point a bit ambitious. But like I said, I think going into next season, that will be the true test of Christian Pulisic, and whether not only can he achieve a lot of good stuff statistically, but like you said, whether he can help Chelsea in terms of the winning column and help them get big results. We saw it after the restart. Now can he do that for a full season? One last question regarding Pulisic, Bo. How do you think his role will change, or how do you think the bringing in of new players like Werner, like Ziyech, could affect his role and his confidence under Frank Lampard? Because we've seen Lampard, he doesn't really put a lot of trust in his players, you could argue, as he's willing to change the lineup quite often. How do you think that could impact Pulisic? Could it be a good thing? Could it motivate him? Or do you think it could be a bad thing and hurt his confidence, potentially hinder that potential?
I think if you had asked me during football, before football had restarted, when we were in lockdown, if you had asked me, oh, how does Pulisic fit into this new look Chelsea with the likes of Werner and Ziyech, I would have said, oh, I don't know, he has some competition. But I think since football's restarted, he's been Chelsea's probably best player going forward. And I think at least to begin the season, he's gonna be in that starting lineup. And then it's just about performing. I mean, the thing with Chelsea next year is they're just gonna have so much depth going forward. I mean, if you think about it, already this year they have tons of talent going forward, and they've just brought in two world-class players, and potentially a third, and if the Havertz deal goes through, excuse me. But I think Pulisic, his spot is safer now, but it's all about continuing to perform. I think he'll continue to play out wide, out right, and Ziyech out left, or vice versa, and Werner up front. I think Mason Mount will play more in the middle in that 4-3-3 formation, and I think all Pulisic's spot is safe as long as he continues to perform, because I think, like I said, the Chelsea team, they've got Callum Hudson-Odoi, they've got Mason Mount, they've got so many talented players, Tammy Abraham, to come off that bench, that if Pulisic isn't clicking, Lampard can just bring another. And like you said, he's not afraid to make big changes in big moments. So I think as long as he continues to perform, that spot is his.
All right, Bo, for the final decision, do you think Christian Pulisic will be able to reach that peak level? In a word, yes or no, let me know.
No.
Okay, I'm gonna say no as well. I kind of wish I gave myself a little explanation. But guys, we will end it there. Neither of us believe that Pulisic will ever be able to hit that peak level of Eden Hazard, but we both believe that he will be one of the best footballers in the world at some point throughout his career. I think he could be a top 10 player at some point. Would you agree with that statement, Bo?
No.
Oh, wow. So we do feel different. I believe Pulisic has the potential to be a top 10 footballer in the world at some point throughout his career. Bo does not. But we will end it there, guys. Thank you guys for tuning in. Let me know down below in the comments, what do you think Christian Pulisic's peak and potential will be at Chelsea Football Club. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to smash that like button and subscribe to the channel as well. Also, go check out Bo's channel, Inside Arsenal. Very good Arsenal content. I'm not sure if you Chelsea fans will necessarily like it, but definitely go check it out. It's one of the better things on YouTube for sure. And yes, we will end it there. Thank you. Take it easy. Peace. I see the blue in her eyes from the sunshine. See the purple in her heart when it's nighttime. She just wanna be in her right mind. She couldn't give a damn about the limelight. So orchestrate your day.